About trigonometry. What is trigonometry? Why we have to learn trigonometry? What is the use of trigonometry in our daily life? Heights, heavy heights using trigonometry. Without trigonometry, we can't find that type of heights. Okay? Right. Now, what is trigonometry? Trigonometry is derived from Greek language. It is the combination of three words. That is, first is tri, gonia, and metron. What is mean by tri? Tri means three. Gonia, in Greek language, gonia means angle. Metron, to measure. So here, it's a combination of three Greek words, trigonometry. So, the great Greek mathematician Hipparchus developed the relation between sides and angles of a right angle triangle. See, how to say it is a right angle triangle? One angle is 90 degrees, it is called right angle triangle. So, suppose what are the angles and what are the sides of a right angle triangle? See, it has three angles, angle A, angle B, angle C. And there are three sides, AB, BC, and AC are the three sides of a right angle triangle. The mathematician Hipparchus developed the relation between these three angles and these three sides of a right angle triangle. So here it is a combination of to measure the relation between the angles and sides of a right angle triangle. Total trigonometry depends on right angle triangle. Without right angle triangle, we can't define trigonometry. So here, what we know about right angle triangle? So one angle is 90 degrees, it is called right angle triangle. Another one, if a triangle satisfies Pythagoras law, then the triangle is called right angle triangle. What is Pythagoras theorem? What is Pythagoras law? In every right angle triangle, longest side square equals to sum of the squares of the other two sides. So what is Pythagoras theorem? In a right angle triangle, longest side square equals to sum of the squares of the other two sides. What is the longest side in right angle triangle? So this longest side is called hypotenuse. In right angle triangle, the longest side is called hypotenuse, and this base is called adjacent, and this is angle theta. So here the angle opposite side of the angle is called opposite. So from Pythagoras theorem we can write hypotenuse square is equal to opposite square plus adjacent square. So longest side square equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides is called Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras law. Okay, every right angle triangle satisfies Pythagoras law. So using this Pythagoras theorem, we can find the angles and sides of a right angle. So here, trigonometry, the word trigonometry derived from Greek language. It is a combination of three Greek words, tri, gonia, metron. So tri means three, gonia means angle, metron means to measure the three angles of a triangle. The father of trigonometry is Greek mathematician Hipparchus, great Greek mathematician. He developed the relation between sides and angles of a right angle triangle. So every right angle triangle satisfies Pythagoras law. What is Pythagoras law? So in a right angle triangle, highest longest side square equals to sum of the squares of the other two sides. That is, in a right angle triangle, the longest side is called hypotenuse, and base is called adjacent, the third side is opposite. In Greek language, angle is denoted by theta. This is the symbol of theta. This is called angle. Any angle, we can denote the angle by using theta. So here in trigonometry we have six trigonometric ratios. What are the six trigonometric ratios? Very first one is sine. First two trigonometric ratios is sine. Second one is cosine. Third one is tangent. Fourth one is potent, secant, and cosecant. So this sign is called, simply we can write it in short word, sine, and some angle theta, cosine, cos theta, tangent, tan theta. While writing tan, always this should be small letter, cot theta, secant theta, and last one is cosec theta. Sine we can write sin, cosine we can write cos, tangent we can write tan, cotant cot, secant sec, and cosecant cosec. Here this theta is the angle again. So here we have, these are the six trigonometric ratios. There is a relation between one ratio with another ratio. See, if you know sine and cos, we can define remaining ratios easily. We'll discuss later. So here in trigonometry, we have some standard angles. We have some standard angles. What are the standard angles? We'll learn. So see, what are the standard angles? 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90 are the standard angles. 0 degrees, 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 60 degrees and 90 degrees are the standard angles in trigonometry. So, we here, what is sine value? Means sine theta, sine 0, sine 30, sine 45, sine 60, sine 90. Similarly, cos theta, tan theta, cot theta, secant theta, and finally cosec theta. What is sine? Sine 0, sine 30, sine 45, sine 60, sine 90. So here we have one logic to find the values. Find the values. So first, how many values are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So write 0, 1, 2, 3, here 5 values, here also we have, right? 5 values, start with 0. Okay, what is the highest number? 4. Divide each number by 4. Simplified, 0 by something is 0. 1 by 4 is 1 by 4. 2 1s are, 2s are, 2 by, sorry, 1 by 2, 3 by 4, and 4 by 4 is 1. Find the square root of each and every number. Find the square root of each and every number. So square root of 0 is 0, square root of 1 by 4 is 1 by 2, square root of 1 is 1, square root of 4 is 2, square root of 1 is 1, square root of 2 is root 2, root 3 by square root of 3 is root 3, square root of 4 is 2, root 1 is 1. These are the values of sine. This is the logic to remember the values. So first we have to take 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, because there are 5 values here, so we have to take 5 values. Each value is divided by highest number. 4 is highest, so divide by 4. Simplified, we get some values. Find the square root of each and every value, we get the result. These are the sine. Sine 0 is 0, sine 30 is 1 by 2, sine 45 is 1 by root 2, root 3 by 2, and this. Now reverse it, we will get cos. 1, root 3 by 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by 2, 0. Here, tan, how to define tan? Tan is equal to sin theta by cos theta. Sin theta by cos theta. Sin value by cos value. 0 by something is 0. 1 by 2 by root 3 by 2. 1 by 2 by root 3 by 2. 2 to get cancelled. What we get? 1 by root 3. So that is 1 by root 3. 1 by root 2 by 1 by root 2 cancel 1, root 3 by 2 by 1 by 2, root 3, and something by 0 is not defined, that is called infinity. This is called not defined, NT, not defined. Okay, sine and cos are complementary ratios. Sine and cos are complementary ratios. The reverse of sine is cos. Similarly, tan and cot are complementary ratios. Tan and cot are complementary ratios. The reverse that reverse it, you get cot. So here not defined, root 3, 1, 1 by root 3 and this is what?
0.
So here secant we can define as 1 by cos im, we can cot is equal to cos by sin also we can write cos theta by sin theta, 1 by cos and this is 1 by sin. Okay, 1 by cos, 1 by 1, 1. 1 by 1 is 1. 1 by 1 by 2 is 2. 1 by 1 by root 2 is root 2. 1 by 1 by root 3 is 2 by root 3. Reciprocal. Sorry. So this is secant is 1 by cos of, we have taken cos values. That is what? 2 by root 3, root 2, 2 and something by 0. Something by 0 is not defined. Something by 0 is 1 by 0 is not defined. So because the secant and cosec are complementary ratios, secant and cosec are complementary ratios, reverse it, you get not defined. 2 root 2, 2 by root 3 and finally 1. This is about trigonometric circle. So using these angles we can find other angles. We have some properties we will discuss later. Now using right angle triangle, how to define trigonometric ratios? Using right angle triangle, how to define the trigonometric ratios? We will learn. See,
sin and cos.
complementary ratios. Secant cos are complementary ratios. And tan and cot are complementary. Secant and cosec are complementary. And here, sin theta is equal to 1 by cosec theta. R cosec theta is equal to, R we can write, cosec theta is equal to 1 by sin theta. See here from the definition, cosec theta is equal to 1 by sin theta. R sin theta is equal to 1 by cosec theta. So if you cross multiply, what we get? Sin theta into cosec theta is equal to 1. So simply from this one we can define as sin and cosec are reciprocals. Similarly, cos theta and secant theta is equal to 1. Cos and secant are reciprocals. And tan theta, cot theta is equal to reciprocal. Simply we can write here, cos theta is equal to 1 by secant theta. R secant theta is equal to 1 by cos theta. Here we can write tan theta is equal to 1 by cot theta. R cot theta is equal to 1 by tan theta. This is the relation between ratios.